still ahead, I should say, new for you tonight. The University of Connecticut is getting a new president, and the school is buying him a new house. UConn already has a house on campus for the president, but the school is spending well over $700,000 to buy another one. Chief Capitol reporter Susan Raff is live on the UConn campus tonight with more on some outrage from lawmakers. Susan, good evening.
Good evening, Mark. UConn is being criticized by at least one lawmaker for spending too much money, he says, trying to make their presidents happy. He says that's the wrong thing to do, especially since UConn keeps asking students and taxpayers for more money.
When UConn's new president starts his job August 1st, Tom Katsalaeus will be living in this home on Gurleyville Road. The home is 5,000 square feet and sits on 5 acres. UConn doesn't own this home. They're buying it for $740,000. The board approved the sale.
It's just catering to whatever president comes in. Every time a president comes in, they want something different. They want a remodel. They don't want to live in that house. They want their own.
The Republican Senate Minority Leader says almost every year, UConn's tuition has gone up. Len Fasano feels spending lots of money on new homes is wasteful. UConn has been leasing this home for many years, putting in $500,000 to renovate it and paying taxes. Former President Michael Hogan lived here because he didn't want to live in this large brick house, which has always been the president's home. The home on Oak Hill Road is 80 years old, and UConn has renovated that as well, but it needs extensive repairs. Regarding the new home, UConn says no money from tuition, student fees, or UConn state appropriation will be used toward the home's purchase. Outgoing President Susan Herbst technically had two homes, this one on campus and this very large house on Scarborough Street in Hartford. The UConn Foundation bought the West End home in 2013 so that Herbst could entertain big money donors and stay here when she had business in Hartford. The UConn Foundation is separate from the university. It's a nonprofit that raises money for UConn. The foundation has taken some heat in recent years after a donor gave $200,000 for Hillary Clinton to speak at the university.
Foundation money could be used to help ease the pain of tuition. And foundation money comes from alumni, boosters, other supporters. They say they're using property from or money from the rental property. All of that could be used to reduce the tuitions.
So what are the plans for the current president's home, the older home here on campus? At this point, it seems it's just going to be used for functions and events. We did reach out to the Board of Trustees and the Hartford Foundation. We have not received a comment from them. It is not uncommon for presidents to be given houses and big salaries. The outgoing president was making over $600,000. The incoming president, over $500,000. We are live at UConn in stores. Susan Raff, Channel 3, Eyewitness News.
All right.